Hi all, welcome back to myclass.com. In this video, I'm going to explain about insertion sort, its technique, its algorithm and analysis of algorithm also. So let's see. Insertion sort. This is an in-place comparison based sorting algorithm. It is an in-place sorting algorithm. What is an in-place sorting algorithm? This insertion sort does not require an extra more space to compare the elements. Here a sublist is maintained which is always sorted. The technique is we are maintaining two sublists. One is sorted and other one is unsorted sublist. The lower part of an array is maintained to be sorted and an element which is to be inserted. It is in the unsorted sublist. We are inserting it into the sorted sublist. Before inserting, we must find its appropriate place and then it must be inserted there. Hence, the name is insertion sort. We are picking an element from the unsorted sublist and inserting that element into our sorted sublist into the its appropriate place. Okay. We are not maintaining an extra array for sorted sublist and unsorted sublist. Inside the same array, we are maintaining this two sublist. Okay. The array is searched sequentially and unsorted items are moved and inserted into sorted sublist. That is in the same array. Okay. For that, lots of comparison is taking place. Because of that, it is not suitable for large data set as its average and worst case complexities are order of n square, where n is the number of items. Now, we are looking to insertion sort algorithm. Algorithm starting with the first element. Okay. If it is the first element, it is already sorted. We are considering that that is already sorted. So that is our sorted sublist and remainings are our unsorted sublist. Now pick the next element. Pick the next element and compare this element into all elements in the sorted sublist. Then shift all the elements in the sorted sublist that is greater than. If we are sorting in increasing order, we are comparing all the elements in the sorted sublist that is greater than that elements we are shifting. We are shifting and now then after the shifting, we will get the appropriate place and in that appropriate place, we are inserting that picked value. Like that, this insertion sort algorithm working. Let's see our algorithm is insertion. A is the name of the array and n is the total number of elements. In this example, n equal to 7. We have two loops in this algorithm. An outer loop and inner loop. The outer loop is working from k 1 to n. K equal to 1 to n. 1 to n means up to n minus 1. So in this example 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 times that is n minus 1 times our outer loop working. In the outer loop we are repeating step 2, 3 and 4. Step 2 is we are picking an element from the unsorted sublist that is temp equal to a of k. If we are taking a value that is storing into our temp a of k. Now we want to start checking all the elements of the sorted sublist. Okay, that is if we are picking 25, we want to compare these two elements with 25. Is it? So it is starting from 1 up to 1 we want to check. That is when k equal to 1 we want to check from k ptr equal to k minus 1 to 0. Okay. So we are starting ptr equal to k minus 1. Repeat while we are checking two condition in this while ptr greater than or equal to 0. Up to the 0 index we want to compare the picked elements and also we want to check if the picked value if 25 is we are picking 25 is less than or equal to our a of ptr. If 25 is less than 34, now only we want to shift, otherwise we don't want to shift. Okay, if these two conditions are true, we are doing a of ptr plus 1 equal to a of ptr. We are shifting this 34 into this 25 place. Okay, now we are decrementing ptr equal to ptr minus 1, then again we are checking, but again, so first we have checked this, now we want to check with 14. So 25 is less than 40, no. So this is not going to work. So at that time our ptr equal to 0. So our correct place is ptr plus 1 as the correct place for 25. So in step 4, a of ptr plus 1 equal to temp. We are inserting that 25 into correct place. Like that, this work is going on, and after all the loop working, we will get the correct sorted list. Okay, so this is the algorithm, contains only 5 steps, 2 loops. First loop is k equal to 1 to n, other is starting from ptr equal to k minus 1 up to 0. Always checking this compare value, and if it is picked values less than, then only we are shifting this elements. Okay, so in the internal loop, what is going on, that we will check here. Okay, so in this example, our outer loop is working k equal to 1 to k equal to 6. Okay, so this is the working of k equal to 1. In k equal to 1, our temp value equal to 30. So in the inner loop is working only one times, because the sorter sublist only containing one value. Okay, so we are compared with the 34 and 14. So it is no need to compare, because it is always greater. So the internal loop is not working in this particular time. But if it is lesser, the internal loop, inner loop is working one time. Okay. If here 34 is not there, here only 3. So we want to exchange this 3 and 14. Isn't we want to shift 14 into here, and we want to update this a of 0 as our picked value if it is less than. But in this case, it is greater, so no need to do the internal loop. If it is lesser, it is working one time. Okay, now k equal to 2, at the time of k equal to 2, temp equal to 25. So maximum we want to compare how many times, 2 times, is it 2 times, when ptr equal to 1 and ptr equal to 0. So first we are checking ptr equal to 1, so 25 is less than 34. So the internal loop, what is going to be working in the internal loop, we are shifting 34 into a of ptr plus 1 value. Okay, so we are shifting 34 to here. So at that moment, our array contains 234, no need to worry. Again, we are checking our 25 with 14, but it is 25 is greater than 14, so no need to shift. Okay, so at that time, our ptr is 0. Our appropriate place for 25 is a of ptr plus 1, a of 1. So we are shifting, we are inserting 25 here. Okay, so in this case, actually, we are compared and shifting only one time. We are only shifted 34, is it, one time. But maximum, how many times we want to shift? 2 times. Okay, maximum 2 times. Here also maximum 1, k equal to 1, maximum 1 time we want to check and shift. When k equal to 2, we want to check 2 times and we want to shift 2 times at the worst case. Okay, like that this insertion sort is working. When k equal to 3, see our temp value is 10, so we want to compare 10 with 34 and 10 with 25 and 10 with 14 also. So 3 times, maximum 3 times here also working, is it? We are shifting 34 here, 25 to here, and then we are shifting 14 to here, then only this much times we are working up to ptr 2, 1 and 0. Okay, so at that time we can identify that ptr plus 1 is our correct value. When ptr equal to 0, the 14 is shifted to here, is it? 14 is shifted to here, then we are decrementing ptr. So at that time ptr equal to minus 1. We are inserting 10 into a of ptr plus 1, minus 1 plus 1, that is a of 0. So as the first value, we are updating 10. Okay, so maximum 3 times here the inner loop had worked here. Okay, when k equal to 4, in this particular case we are picking 36, but 36 is greater when compared to our sorted sublist, then no need to do any internal loop working. So in this case it is 0 times working. But the worst case, maybe it is the very lowest element we have taken here, then maximum 1 2 3 4 times this internal loop should work. Okay, 4 times, maximum 4 times. When k equal to 5, we want to pick 18. Then we want to compare this 18 with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times at maximum level. So first we are comparing with 36. So it is lesser, 18 is lesser. So we are shifting we are shifting 36 to here. Now we are checking 34 with 18. It is also 18 is lesser, so we are shifting. Now we are compare with 25. 25 is also greater than 18, so we are shifting. Now we are checking. So at PTR equal to 1, we are checking 18 is less than equal to 14. No. So the inner loop is not going to work. So we have got the correct PTR plus correct value to be inserted. So we are inserting at the position PTR plus 1. That is, when PTR equal to 1, PTR plus 1 is A of 2. A of 1 plus 1, A of 2. So we are inserting 18 to A of 2 position. Okay. So in this particular example, this inner loop worked how many times? 1, 2, 3 times. 3 times, is it? So maximum how much times it would work? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. When equal to k equal to 5, it should work up to 5 times in its maximum. When k equal to 6, our picked value is 43, but 43 is the very greatest element among all this element. So no need to do the internal loop in this particular case, is it? Otherwise, if 43 is not there, here the value is 3. Let's assume that 3 is here. So at that time we want to check all the previous values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times. So when k equal to 6, maximum 6 times the inner loop going to be work. It is in the worst case situation. So that is the working of insertion sort. Now according to that, when we are analyzing the best case and worst case, first want to analyze the best case. What should be the best case? If the elements we want to sort in an increasing order and our input array is also in a correct sorting order, that is the best case, is it? So at the best case, the outer loop is working but the inner loop is does not going to work. If k equal to 1, it is 14 is compared with 10. No, we are not entering into our inner loop. Okay, then when k equal to 2 also we are not entering into our loop. So up to 6, so n minus 1 times the outer loop is only working. So order of n minus 1 means we are only taking the n term. So order of n, or so we are taking order of n. So order of n is the best case complexity of insertion sort. Okay, our best case complexity is order of n. Now, which one is the worst case? We want to do an increasing order sorting and our input value is decreasingly sorted. That is the worst case, is it? So, at the worst case, in this example, our k value is up to 6, is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, when k equal to 1, we want to do the internal loop one time, is it? When k equal to 2, maximum we want to do the internal loop up to 2 times. We want to 34 is lesser than 36 and 42. So we want to do all this comparison and shifting. So 2 times we are doing the inner loop. And when k equal to 3, 3 times we are doing. 3 times we want to check and shift. When k equal to 4, we are doing 4 times. Like that we are doing in the worst case situation. Okay, so we can generalize this like how much time we can write like this. Is it 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 6 means up to n minus 1. Our n value is 7. Okay, so this is the summation series of natural numbers up to n minus 1. So the result of this series is n into n minus 1 by 2. N square minus n square minus n by 2. You can write like n by 2 minus n by n square by 2 minus n by 2. Our worst case is order of n square. Okay. And also we can say that our average case complexity is order of n square. Okay. Our best case is order of n. Worst and average case are order of n square. Okay. That is all about insertion sort code analysis. Thank you.